Tucker.
Yeah.
Come on, guys. Come be called on. Terrible call down here.
Thank you.
Get this rebound. Let's go.
Backside,
Katie!
Backside!
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 Backside! Let's be sure to stop by and stop by the lobby. They've got the American Heart Association display there. You can have your blood pressure checked. All kinds of goodies out there, great information. They also have a raffle on our beautiful Valentine wreath on display.
They all
we'll have the going yes, for that at halftime. Chances to win that wreath, only a dollar. And you're helping the American Heart Association. And once again, all that is out in the lobby. Check it out.
Yeah, I got to make a website.
Hey, how much red meat, how much red sauce you had on the burger? It eats like a damn thing.
Thank you.
Hold on, I put the headphones on. Now I got it. Yeah, I hear it fine.
Jim in Fairley tonight. The Greenbrier Spartans at home to take on the Bluefield Beavers. Jeff Campbell, Casey Crane, Spartan basketball on a Friday night in Fairley. Casey, this game tonight features a couple teams that played about 10, 12 days ago. They lost 70-57 down to Brush Fork National Guard Armory. And this game's going to be different tonight. Mookie Collier is not playing.
Out tonight testing for the SAT or ACT tomorrow, one or the other. And then they got several kids out with the flu, so they moved a couple JV guys up. Only had seven guys dressing JV for Bluefield tonight, so it's been interesting to see what they do numbers-wise. I know they've had a bunch of these guys sick, but just they're still a talented team that knows how to win. As far as got to play well, they're going to have a chance to stay in this game tonight.
We'll come back, talk with East Coach Bimbo Coles after this 60-second timeout. You're listening to the Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan Countdown on 103.1 The Bear. 60. Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan Countdown on 103.1 to Bear. We're talking with East Head Basketball Coach Bimbo Coles. And Coach, back on Tuesday night, Spartans go on the road down to Riverside and take on a Riverside team that's up and coming as well. They win that game 85-67.
Yeah, it was a hard-fought game. You know, I think the difference of the game was is they shot probably 20 or 25 more free throws than we did. You know, the one player of theirs, number one, shot 22 free throws himself. So that's a big difference in the game with the free throws. Our guys played hard. We missed some shots, and we didn't take advantage of some opportunities that we had. But over and all, the guys continued to fight hard. And, you know, we continue to get better. Our record's not showing it, but the guys are improving. We just got to go out and put 32 minutes of a ball game together. In order for us to get wins, we got to be out and play a complete game.
In terms of where you're at now to where you were earlier in the year, you mentioned a minute ago you're improving. Talk about that progress you're seeing.
Well, it's so many things have come into play for us this year. You know, first it was like give me 100% effort and play every single possession. And then it was like, you know, the effort is starting to be there, but I want the competitiveness. I want to see you compete. Now we're starting to go out and do that. It's all about us, you know, doing the little things, you know, take care of the basketball, rebounding the basketball, and then putting 32 minutes of basketball in and going out and executing our offense. You know, them are the little things that we need to continue to get better at. And we are, but it's still, like you know, a lot of people keep telling me it's going to take a little bit of time, but we're going to continue to work hard.
Corey Beswick, he's back last couple of games after, you know, going through that concussion issue that he had. Where is he at now to where he was before all that took place?
I think he's just starting to get better. You know, when you have a concussion, you know, I think it's more mental than anything. You know, the kids don't want to get their head bumped. They don't want to fall down. They're not as aggressive as they normally are. They're shy about some of the contact sometimes. And I've seen this with him and Bailey. But he's starting to get his bearings back a little bit. They're going to start him tonight. Also going to start Bailey. And, you know, hopefully we'll get what we need out of him.
We talked a few games ago about Zion Jeter, who had, you know, played really strong around the basket, just had to just almost snake bit in terms of being able to finish. Seems like his last few games, he's starting to finish and those shots are starting to fall.
Yeah, you know, Z's continue to work his tail off, and, you know, that's what I keep telling him. Keep working your tail off, and the shots are starting to, they'll fall for you. One of the things we've starting to do with him in practice is, you know, when we break up bigs and guards that, you know, we split ends and we have bigs go, we've got the dummy football pads out, and we're starting to hit them a bunch when they get the ball inside. So that makes them focus a little bit more, and it makes it more game situation, and he's starting to finish a little bit more now.
Okay, I got to ask you about the situation that took place in the fourth quarter the other night that resulted in some technical fouls on both sides. And for Greenbrier East, Justin Davis was ejected, had two technical fouls, and he's going to be out for a couple of games.
Yeah, he's going to be out for two games. But, you know, what Justin did when the game at the game was, you know, basically he had his teammates back. You know, the kid did something to Bryson, and Bryson didn't like it. And then the big fella jumped in, and Justin had his back, which is, you know, something that we continue to preach is, you know, understanding team concept. You know, the biggest thing was we didn't want him getting in a fight, and that's what it looked like it was getting ready to happen at half court. And, you know, that was the disappointing thing is that we don't want our kids to fight. We want them to have each other's back, but we don't want them to go out and fight. And it looked like he was getting ready to fight. So, you know, it's another lesson for us. You know, we continue to preach, you got each other's back, but we don't want to fight at all.
Okay, now what does that do to your team? Because you really don't have a true post player as you've had in the last, you know, couple of games. In fact, you know, without him and no longer Rozelle.
Well, it's just next man up. You know, we're going to play, you know, of course, we'll start Z at the five, and Logan's going to get an opportunity to play. We'll go real small and have Logan play the five some. We're going to have two of our JV guys come up that's been playing well and have them play the five some. So, you know, it's next man up. You know, we keep moving a guy in there and see what we got. You know, the biggest thing for us is how we go out and give effort and how we compete.
This is the Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan Countdown on 103.1 to Bear. 60. We're going to be ready to go in a minute. Are we going to be ready to go in a minute? Ready, just welcome back to the Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan Countdown. We're talking with East Head basketball coach Bimbo Coles. And, coach, tonight Bluefield Beavers come to town. We went down there week before last, and you look at this game tonight, a couple of different things are different. They'll begin with Mookie Collier, Bluefield's, you know, their star player who won the Kennedy Award, will not be playing tonight for Bluefield.
Oh, wow. Well, you know.
A little breaking news there?
Yeah, that's breaking news for me. It doesn't matter. Bluefield's still very good. You know, they're a very talented team. And, you know, it's just like everybody else. The guy gets hurt, it's the next man up. Bluefield has a great program, well coached, and they got players that know how to play. So We still expect the same Bluefield team. They're still going to be tough as nails, but it is a lot better for us if Mookie's not playing, that's for sure.
You look at the game there week four last, and it was 70-57. Bluefield wins that game. I thought really that was kind of a game where we turned a corner, fell behind early, and then really battled back and cut it down to single digits much of the second half.
Yeah, well, you know, we were down 20 points in the first quarter, so we played them pretty tight, you know, quarters three through four, and we won them quarters. You know, three quarters we win, and we down by 20 in the first quarter. So we need to come out strong. You know, after that game, talking to some of their players, they realized that we're not as bad as our record, and I think they'll come ready to play, and I think our guys is ready for the challenge.
Good luck tonight. We'll talk to you tomorrow at Capital Midland.
All right, thank you.
This is the Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan Countdown on 103.1 The Bear. Okay. Play spots until I tell you to. I'm monitoring. I'll know how many you're into. Neither team's out on the court yet, and we're supposed to be starting by now. Hey, will you put that other one in? After this spot, throw it back to me. Throw it back after this spot. Hold on. It's time now to meet the starting lineups for tonight's game, Greenbrier East and the Bluefield Beavers. And for that, let's send it over to our public address announcer, Mr. Gary Aide.
Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to Greenbrier East High School. Our game tonight features the Greenbrier Spartans and the Bluefield Beavers. As many of you know, February is Heart Month, so at halftime, Greenbrier East will have a special presentation by Dr. Tom Von Dolan from the Heart Center here in Fairleigh. Dr. Von Dolan, along with the American Heart Association, hopes to bring awareness about the importance of taking your heart and knowing the warning signs, taking care of your heart and knowing the warning signs of a heart in distress. Cardiovascular disease is the number one cause of death in the United States, killing more people than the next five leading causes of death combined, including all forms of cancer. Know your blood pressure numbers and take your medication as prescribed. Your life depends on it. As I mentioned, we'll have more on heart health coming up at halftime. In the meantime, let's meet our teams, and we'll begin with Bluefield. Under the direction of head coach Buster Large, please welcome number two, Chandler Cooper. Number 11, Jaheim House. Number 21, Dominic Texley. Number 23, Juice Edwards. And please welcome number 30 for Bluefield, Braden Cruz. That's the starting lineup for the Bluefield Beavers.
No retreat, no surrender. That is Spartan law. And by Spartan law, we will stand and fight. Spartans never retreat. Spartans never surrender. Spartans prepare for glory!
Direction of head coach Bimbo Coles. Please welcome the Greenbrier Spartans. 6'1 freshman number 1, Q Wilson. 6'1 sophomore number 5, Tyler Young. 6'1 junior number 10, Dave Kastner. 5'11 senior number 35, Jason Dodd. 5'7 freshman number 23, Tucker Vine. 5'8 freshman number 1, Clay Jackson. 6'1 sophomore number 20, Hunter Baker. A 5'9 senior number 21, Devin Persinger. A 6'1 senior number 34, Logan Taylor. Now please welcome the starting lineup for the Spartans. A 6'1 freshman number 12, Bailey Coles. 6'1 junior number 4, Corey Beswick. A 6'1 junior number 0, Zion Jeter. 5'11 senior number 22, Bryson Penn. And please welcome a 6'4 senior number 2, Nathan Lemons. That's the starting lineup for the Greenbrier East Spartans. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we honor America with our national anthem. Singing the anthem, we're pleased to welcome Lyrica Pence.
Our referees for tonight, it's Mike Nisley, Josh Wright, and Billy Keaton. Spartans in the home whites. Bluefield in that traveling blue, Shamara blue uniform. Casey, we've kind of grown to like this one over the years.
Yeah, it's a nice look for them. I mean, they're typically maroonish, white, and gray, but they've got the occasional blue they wear in football and basketball, and it's a sharp look.
Josh Wright with the ball in the center circle, tap controlled here by the Bluefield Beavers. Juice Edwards controls the tap, sends the pass out front to Brandon Cruz. They'll work it down in the corner now, over to Taxley, the ball knocked away. Here's a steal by Penn. Gives it over now to Jeter, into the front court. Lemons drives, kicks it over the corner to Coles. Ball tipped away. Here comes Bluefield back up the floor. Chandler Cooper will drive, shoot, no good. Rebound is saved by Jeter in the hands of Bluefield's Brandon Cruz, and the Beavers will slow it down and set up the offense.
Gotta wonder, Jeff, when things get tight, Bluefield's always gone to Collier the last 3 years. Gotta wonder what they're gonna do to find those points or when things are tight tonight, who's gonna step up.
Here's Beavers with it now. Juice Edwards sends it cross court, and they throw it away. It's going to be Spartan basketball. East possession. No score. We played 50 seconds here in Fairley. Inbound comes into Coles, and he is fouled on a push down low by Juice Edwards.
That'll be Edwards' first team, number one.
Bluefield with full court man. Baseball pass is thrown and intercepted by the Beavers. Here's House with it on the right wing. Sends a cross court on the left side to Chandler Cooper. He'll go out top to Juice Edwards. Back over to Cooper. Squared for three. It's in the air and it's stuck between the backboard and the rim. Jump ball possession arrow points to Greenbrier East. Still no score. Penn gets it in now to Beswick, draws a double team. Now a triple team, and he is going to get tied up in possession to Bluefield. So the Spartans essentially with a turnover that time as the Beavers come in and converge down on Corey Beswick.
Beswick tried to get the timeout, but the official called the jump ball before he recognized the timeout.
Inbound pass goes in now for Juice Edwards. Ball knocked away, controlled here by Jeter. He'll give it over now to Beswick. Into the front court, over to Lemons on the right side. Lemons brings it out front, sends it out top to Penn, finds a lane, drives, shoots. Ball is loose, controlled underneath by Jeter. He puts it up, can't fall, rebound Bluefield. Here comes House down the other end of the floor, gives it over to running Cruz in the lane, scores. Brandon Cruz. At the 6:20 mark, scores the first points of the game. Bluefield leads 2-0.
Ball kicked out by Cruz now.
Bimbo wants a timeout. 6:12 to go in the first. Bluefield leads 2-0. Spartan basketball at 103.1 to Bear. First quarter, Bluefield leads it here 2-0, and Bimbo saw something he didn't like at that quick 30.
Well, I think what it was against inbounding against the press, you have to keep inbounding the ball to the corner and allowing the Bluefield to instantly double team. That's how Beswick got tied up on alternating possession. That time they did it as soon as they passed the court, it was kicked out, and he took a timeout to say, don't pass it, keep the ball in the middle.
Into the front court comes Greenbrier. Beswick finds a lane, drives in, shot will fall, rebound knocked out of bounds. It'll be Bluefield basketball. As Jeter went crashing in for the offensive rebound, went off his hands and out of bounds. Possession to the Beavers, leading here 2-0. Up we go the other way with it. Bluefield down to Juice Edwards, kicks it off over in the corner to Cooper. He'll drive down the lane. Nice spin move and scores. Bluefield leading 4-0. Lead pass down to the front court for Coles. Draws a double team. Bluefield aggressive defensively and Coles travels. Bluefield basketball with a 4-0 lead. He'll get it in now for Bluefield. Down the floor with it comes Taxley. He'll drive in. Shot up, no good. Cheater skies for the rebound. Gives it over to Beswick. Here comes Beswick down the right side. Feeds Coles. Coles inside. Jukes scores on a foul. Coles finishes and draws the foul on Bluefield. A chance for the three-point play.
That foul will go on Juice Edwards. That's two quick ones on him already. Keep in mind, Bluefield is very depleted on the bench right now. So anybody gets in foul trouble for them, they're going to be playing guys that are mostly, except once they get past the first seven, Jeff, you're talking about JV guys.
Coles scores the three-point play. 5:20 of the first quarter. It's 4-3 Beavers. Spartans aggressive defensively. Bluefield breaks it in the front court. Here's House. A shot down the elbow. Scores on a runner down the lane. It's 6-3 Beaver. Back comes East up the other end of the floor. Shot put up down low by Lemons. It'll be knocked out of bounds, and it's going to belong to Greenbrier East.
Now we'll see Blevins and Coleman check in for Bluefield. Got to think Juice Edwards coming out with his two quick fouls.
Here's the inbound to corner. A three ball up by Beswick is good. We're tied at six. Spartans on a 6-2 run. Beswick scores for the first time. At the other end, Beaver dumps it down low. They'll kick it over to Cruz on the left wing. Spartans getting after it defensively. Down on the baseline to Cooper. Cross court. Here's a three up in the air. That one misfired by Ronell Blevins. Rebound controlled by Greenbrier East. Here comes Beswick in a tie game at six. Lemons, corner, three ball by Penn is up, no good. Bounced around, rebound to Bluefield. Here comes House with a lead pass to Cooper, and it's knocked away. Beswick controls. Beswick gives it over to Lemons. Lemons in the corner to Coles, a three in the air, no. Rebound, Jeter turns, shoots, can't fall. Rebounds to Bluefield. Here comes Blevins into the front court. Gives it off to Cruz, right side to Cooper. Back out front, a Cruz NBA range three is no good. Rebound controlled by Jeter. Quick outlet goes to Lemons, under 4:20 left in the first. Down the floor to Penn. Penn on the left side, out top to Jeter from the elbow, 15-footer up and good. Jeter scores in the Spartans lead for the first time, and Buster Large.
No, I think we got a violation here, Jeff. Maybe stepping over the line. I think it's turnover on Bluefield.
Delay of game warning.
So Lemons obviously hit the ball after it went through the basket. And you know who makes that call? That's a college official making that call. You don't see that in high school very often. That's a guy that does a lot of college games. They get that in college. You never hear that in high school.
Into the front court comes Bluefield. Down 8-6. Spartans lead for the first time in this game. Brandon Cruz with it out top. Sends it over to the right side. On the wing. Back out front to Cruz. Getting that last pass was Ronell Blevins. Working around the right side. And a ball knocked away. Persinger's just checked in. He gets the steal. Into the front court. Up top to Beswick. Thought about a three. He'll drive. Kick it over to Lemons. He'll fire the three from the wing. It's good! Nathan Lemons gives East a five-point lead at 11-6. And Bluefield throws it away. That is six turnovers on the Beavers. And Buster Large wants a timeout. It's a full timeout with 3:13 left in the first. Spartans 11, Bluefield 6, East on an 11-2 run. This is Spartan basketball on 103.1 FM.
Did you buy that or somebody give it to you?
Shannon Warren, Don Elwick, or somebody else that works with them. There was WBSO intake yesterday.
Spartan turns on an 11-2 run. Greenbrier East leads it by a score of 11-6. 5-point lead, and Bluefield set to put some pressure on East, and the Spartans bring it easily. Here comes Lemons, drives down the lane, kicks it off to Persinger. Over on Beswick now, back over to Persinger. Too long, three is up, no good. Rebound, Bluefield. And stolen away, Lemons scores, and a foul! Nathan Lemons with the steal and the score, and a foul on Bluefield's Brandon Cruz. It'll be a 3-point opportunity for Nathan Lemons.
That'll be Cruz's first, team third. And Jeff, we're seeing East due to Bluefield, what Bluefield typically does, East, that forced turnovers. Seven turnovers now in 5 minutes of play for Bluefield. And Greenbrier East capitalized, especially that one there, with the opportunity to make a 3-point play.
Lemons hits the foul shot. The Spartans on a 14-2 run. They lead it by eight. It's 14-6, and how about the Spartans getting after Bluefield defensively and putting a little pressure on them that they're not used to seeing?
And I've said at the beginning of the game, you got to wonder what will happen without Collier in there, because he kind of cleans up all the messes, Jeff. No matter what the situation is, he's so crazy athletic. They get him the ball and let him just create things. He's not there tonight. Somebody else got to fill that spot, and that's a big hole.
Bluefield works it around the house. Out front, here's a Cruz three. Shot rims out. Rebound kicked up. No good. Missed by Bluefield again. It's saved now. Into the hands. Down low. Score and a foul. It'll be a basket for Bluefield's Russ Coleman.
That foul will go on Beswick. That'll be his first, team number one.
That breaks that 14-2 run.
Really about three shots that time for Bluefield before Coleman actually scores.
Shot up in the air is good for Coleman. It's 14-9. East by 5 points here over the Beavers. Up the floor comes East with it. Ball is knocked around, and Penn gives it over to Beswick. Out front, back on the right side to Persinger. 2:25 left in the first quarter. Here's Beswick, works over the left side, gives it out front now to Taylor, back on the right side, over to Lemons, corner to Persinger. He'll penetrate to the elbow, 12-footer up in the air, no good, rebound Beaver. House, outlet pass, stolen away by Persinger, gives it over now to Beswick. Barton Ball with a 5-point lead, and they throw it away. Miscommunication between Beswick and the intended receiver, Persinger.
If Persinger going to the basket, Beswick obviously thought Persinger was coming out more towards half court. Persinger never turned his head around, Jeff. He was going hard down, looked like down the block to set a screen. Unfortunate turnover that time. They had just taken the ball from Bluefield, had a chance to extend the lead.
Working around the left side here to Juice Edwards. Out top to Ronnell Blevins. Three ball up. That one's a brick by Cruz, and it's out of bounds. It'll go over to East on the dead ball. Spartans inbound. Beswick into the front court now for Penn. Out top to Beswick. Beswick will penetrate, drive in, shot up, no good. Rebound to Bluefield. Had a nice little finger roll, just didn't finish.
Didn't get the ball high enough.
Into the front court comes Beaver. Pass down the lane. Beautiful pass inside, and Russ Coleman scores. It's 14-11, East by three. Beswick gives it over now to Penn. Out top. They'll wide open. He'll fire the three and knock it in. Beswick's got six. 17-11 East. 70 seconds to go in the first, and the ball knocked away. It's going to be
East ball.
Spartan basketball.
Nine turnovers now, Jeff, this quarter for Bluefield. East with only five, so it's a difference of four, but if you can capitalize on a couple of those, that's stealing points. And we know this East team has struggled to score at times this year.
Inbound comes in. It's over to Penn. Penn into the front court. Ball goes off his foot. Another East turnover. Up the floor comes Beaver. Cooper with it. Up top to Coleman. In the corner, a three ball put up and in for Ronnell Blevins. 17-14. Down to 45 seconds to go in the first. Taylor over to Penn. Penn on the left wing goes out top to Coles. Ball stolen away. Back we go the other way. Here's a drive and a foul on Taylor.
Be his first, team second. So back-to-back turnovers by Penn. You got to think he's coming out now. Bessick will be going in for him. Coach Cole's not happy with Penn's performance there the last two possessions. But Willie, two shots here for Cruz. Bluefield.
First one is up and no good. Second one by Cruz is good. And now sub for Bluefield as Jaheim House will check back in. He'll replace Drake Mullins. It's 17-15 with 35 seconds to go in the first. Inbound to Coles, double teamed in the backcourt, ball stolen away. Bluefield with a takeaway. Here's a shot put up on the right side, no good to Blevins. Rebound Taylor, and he is fouled. That'll go on Bluefield's house.
That'll be his first, team fourth. And you saw again, Jeff, when Coach Coles called timeout because they were inbounding the ball in the corner versus trap. And what happened? We got turnover as soon as they inbounds it to the corner. You can't go to the corner.
And immediately a reach-in foul on Blevins.
That'll be his first, team fifth.
So Bluefield, still with that full court man. East leading by two, it's 17-15. Spartans inbound to Beswick. He's guarded by Cooper. Beswick cross the timeline, gets a screen out top by Persinger, feeds it over to Coles. Coles inside Jeter. Jeter has the ball knocked away, it's out of bounds. Bluefield basketball on the turnover. 7 seconds left in the first quarter.
Three possessions in a row now, Jeff. East has turned the ball over and not even gotten a shot off.
Here's Cruz with it with three out top. Here's a Blevins three at the buzzer. It's no good. And after one, Spartan 17, Bluefield 15. Spartan basketball is on the bear. After one, East leading Bluefield 17-15.
And really, it was East getting the turnovers early against Bluefield, allowing the build to lead, but then Greenbrier East turns it over themselves nine times. Three straight possessions to end the quarter, Jeff. Didn't get a shot off because we turned it over before we got the ball really into play, so got to protect the ball a little bit. They do that, East has shown they can play with these guys. We played with for three quarters down there, one quarter here. Just protect the ball a little bit.
And again, it was that first quarter down at Brush Fork. They really put East in that hole, and so far, so good. Spartans will have ball to begin this second quarter. Taylor will inbound. Gets it into Beswick. East by two. Beswick had 6 points in that first quarter. He'll give it out front. Coles, ball stolen away. Drive, layup shot, good, and a foul on Bailey Coles.
That'll be his first, team third. Basket by Juice Edwards on the steal. Now four straight possessions. Jeff East has turned it over without a shot.
And the free throw is good for Juice Edwards. Bluefield leads it now, 18-17. That's their first
another
lead
steal.
In a while. Another steal. Brandon Cruz scores 20-17. And just like that, Bluefield takes 3-point lead, and Bimbo wants a timeout.
No, it's going to be a foul first. Oh, they're going to give the timeout.
Okay, timeout East. 7:34 to go in the second quarter. Bluefield leads 20-17. Spartan basketball is on the Bear. 60.
Spartan Gym in Fairley, 7 minutes, 34 seconds to go. Bluefield leading Greenbrier East, 20-17. Coach Cole's got a warning there, Jeff, before the timeout, before he went to break. The official went to call a foul at the same time Coach Cole's was calling a timeout. He awarded the timeout, not the foul. Coach Cole's was not happy about that, and the official told him, listen, that's a warning. You can't carry on like that. So Greenbrier East hit with the timeout, and Bluefield gets away with the foul.
East with it, down by three. It's 20-17 Bluefield. And another errant pass without a shot, stolen away by Bluefield. Taylor's got two.
His second, team fourth. Now five straight possessions without a shot. And we have these stretches, Jeff. Every game we play, when we play Bluefield, the first time it was in the first quarter, we had Riverside on the ropes the other night. We had about a three-minute stretch in the second quarter that they kept turning it over and couldn't do anything. We go through these stretches every game. There's a couple minutes. We start turning it over a bunch, and then the game gets out of hand. Now up to East is up to 12 turnovers. Three in the first 40 seconds of this quarter.
Bluefield has it, leading 20-17. Here's Chandler Cooper with it. Out top to Cruz. Right side on the wing. Near side to Edwards.
Got a foul on Beswick. That'll be his second. Team number five.
Here's Bluefield with it. Sometimes you just got to pay your ticket, buy your ticket and be here. The entertainment is priceless.
It's five. It's not play. It's $5. But it's a good laugh.
It is a good laugh. Can't put a value on the laughter. All right. Here's the Bluefield with it. They'll feed it down inside the house. Ball is going to be carried out of bounds. It'll be Spartan basketball. So the Spartans now, Casey, trying to get off a shot on this possession.
Been a while since they've gotten one. Now we've got Blevins for Bluefield checking in and replacing House.
Spartans up the four, down by three. Here's Cheater with it. He'll another turnover, Casey, without a shot.
Yep, that's now six in a row. That's hit Jeter's first, team six. You got to have a plan when you're attacking the basket. That time Jeter just jumped up into the air, really didn't have any idea what to do with the ball, crashed into the Bluefield player, and then tried to throw it. Easy call for the officials.
Bluefield has it. They'll work it over on the left side to Cruz. Cruz double team. Left side over to Coleman. He'll get it down in the corner here to Ronnell Blevins.
Ball was kicked by Beswick.
So it'll stay with Bluefield here with 6:10 to play in the second. Up top to Bluefield. He'll get it over to Brandon Cruz. Cruz, backdoor pass inside, layup shot good. Nice ball movement. Ronnell Blevin scores 22-17. Bluefield now is on an 11-0 run. They lead it by five. Here's a shot put up by Persinger. It's no good. Rebound controlled by Bluefield's Cooper. Cooper into the front court. Works it down on the left side. Shot put up down underneath. They'll call a travel. No shot, no basket, I should say, by Juice Edwards. Up the floor comes Jeter with it. Out front, Beswick for a three. Shot off the front of the rim. Rebound, Bluefield. Cruz, lead pass down the floor. Driving layup good for Edwards. 24-17, Bluefield by seven. Approaching the five-minute mark of this second quarter. Here's Persinger inside it. Jeter, shot won't fall. Rebound to Bluefield. Up the floor to Cooper. Ball stolen away again by Persinger. Persinger leads it down to Coles. He'll drive inside. They're going to call an offensive foul on Bailey Coles. That's two on him and back-to-back charges. In fact, two charges, I should say, in the last four possessions.
Yeah, that's seven out of eight possessions now. East not got off a shot. Well, 7-9. Forgot Jeter missed one last time. So just killing themselves with turnovers. I know we probably sound like a broken record saying that, but there's really not much else to say about East offense. They just keep turning it over.
Yep.
And Bluefield's taking advantage of it with some layups.
Bluefield on a run. Who was that?
That was Cruz.
Cruz for a three. He's got eight. It is 27-17.
Now we got a technical on Coach Coles.
Technical foul on East Coach Bimbo Coles. Casey Bluefield has gone on a 16-0 run. If you extend it back, it'd be a 21-3 run. Two shots for Bluefield. Brandon Cruz. They lead it by 10. Free throw's good.
I've got that as Coach Coles' third technical on the year. Had one at Riverside and at Graham.
And Cruz now hits them both. He's got 10. It is 29-17.
You know, the hardest thing about getting a technical for Coach Coles is, you know, he likes to stand the whole time.
Yeah.
You lose that standing privilege once you get the technical. That also counts as a team foul, so that's team foul number eight on East.
Bluefield with it, leading 29-17. They'll get it down inside, and Ronnell Blevin scores 31-17. 4:20 left in the second quarter. Here comes Persinger, feeds it over to Coles. Coles will drive down the right side and draw a foul on the floor, non-shooting foul. That is team foul number six.
That'll go on Cooper. That'll be his first team six, as you mentioned.
And what do we got? 5 second call against East. They couldn't get it in. Lemon's the trigger man underneath the basket.
Now seven turnovers, Jeff, in 3 minutes and 50 seconds of this quarter.
31-17. Bluefield leads it by 14 points. Backdoor pass down underneath and a travel call on Beaver. 14-point lead. Bluefield on a 25-3 run. Jeter down low. He'll lay it up and score. Boy, he needed that one badly. 31-19.
That should be a charge. That's on Edwards. That'll be his third. I think it is. Yep. Good job by Jeter hustling back. Team foul number seven. Jeter, after making a basket on one end, hustling back and got into Edwards' way. And Edwards just led with his shoulder, Jeff. That's an easy call. The same reason they called it on Coles. If you lead with your shoulder, they're going to call a lot of times. Yep. It's going to lean to an offensive call.
Gabe Kastner has checked in. Bluefield again with full court man. Persinger fires it across timeline to Jeter. Back to Persinger. He'll drive in, and he will draw a foul. Two shots for Devin Persinger.
That'll go on Coleman. That'll be his first for Bluefield, team eight.
Hey, get D back.
Foul shot is up and good for Persinger. 31-20 now.
There you go. Hey, you're going to be back here. Back here. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Second one is up. Got it. He's now scored four straight. They trail by 10, 31-21. Here's Bluefield out front. Cruz with it. Works the right side over to Dominic Taxley. Back out top to Cruz. Now the foul line over to Russ Coleman. Out of the corner, a three ball put up. That one no good. Missed by Blevins. Rebound underneath the Bluefield. And the shot goes up, and the shot goes in for Russ Coleman. 33-21. Into the front court. Here's a shot put up down on the foul line. That one's no good by Persinger. Rebound to Bluefield. Under three to play in the first. In the corner now, the right side for Chandler Cooper. Cooper. Down low, they'll throw it away. Spartan ball. So now Persinger will get it in to Lemons. Back on the left side. Here's a three by Cole. Shot rims out. Rebound to Cruz. Gives it up the floor. He'll drive in all the way. Shot up, no good. Rebound, foul called on Jeter. That'll be a 1-on-1.
That'll be Jeter's second, team ninth.
Foul shot is up. That one no good by Coleman. Bluefield will rebound. Over to Ronnell Blevins. Back on the left side. He'll work it underneath. Here's a drive, a shot. Offensive foul. Correct call on Chandler Cooper. At least they're being consistent about it.
Yeah, I mean, there was no doubt Persinger was in position right there. He held his ground. He wasn't moving. Cooper just flew in. And Cooper's, I'm guessing, looking at his arms and shoulders, he's probably a football player because he's a thick, muscular kid. And no doubt about that. That Persinger held his ground. Now we got a technical foul on somebody. On 10, he hit the out. So we got a technical now. That'll be number two, technical one on House. He hit Persinger as Persinger trying to inbound.
On blue number 10, that will count towards team. That will count towards disqualification for making contact on the throw out of bounds behind the plane.
Touching Persinger out of bounds. That's an automatic technical. I remember I had that called on me one time in school. Just reaching, you know, trying to make a play, and he's got, you can't cross the out of bounds line and touch the inbounds man.
Bailey Coles with the foul shot.
That's how you learn not to do it again, Jeff, after you get called for a technical.
Second one, no good.
Now Beswick and Taylor will check in for Kastner and Persinger. Does this game feel closer to you than 11? I mean, it feels like we're in a dogfight. We're struggling to score because all the turnovers and missing good opportunities. But man, it feels like we're in the middle of a tight postseason game right now.
2:15 left until halftime. Spartans down by 11. Here's a three ball out front by Taylor is no good. Rebound cleared by the Bluefield Beavers. Back we go, the other way. Blevins in the corner. Bounce passes over to Cruz. Cruz with the ball knocked away in the backcourt. They're going to call a foul on Lemons.
That'll be Lemons' first team 10. So it'll be double bonus here for Cruz. Now Tyler Young set to check in for the Spartans.
All right, Tyler Young will check in. Line to our right is Bluefield's Brandon Cruz. 2 minutes left until halftime. And he hits the foul shot.
I've got Cruz for 11 now. The
game's leading scorer. And the second one is good. It's now 35-22, and East is going to throw it away again.
17 turnovers now in the first half. We're on pace, you know, we at this point, 32 against Martinsburg was our most. We're on pace to beat that right now.
Bluefield on the attack over on the right side. Here's Taxley. His pass inside is knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Bluefield. Inbound comes outside to Cruz. 90 seconds to go in the first half. Taxley has his pass stolen away by Lemons. Lead down to Beswick. Layup shot good. Beswick makes it 35-24. Double team by East defense. They'll work it inside instead. Down low to Bluefield's Ronnell Blevins. And it's 37-24. Down to a minute left in the first half.
Got a foul on Taxley. That'll be his first team 10th. This will be double bonus here for Corey Beswick. He's East leading scorer right now with 8.
Foul shot good by East. It's Beswick at the line. He's got 9 points now.
And Coach Coles mentioned the pregame with you, Jeff. He thought he would play better after getting a couple games back under him from coming back from concussion. He's looked like the old Corey Beswick tonight.
Makes one out of two there. It's a 12-point Beaver lead with under a minute to go in the first half. Here's Coleman out top. Feeds it down the house. His shot is up and in. Jaheim House makes it 39-25. 40 seconds to go in the half. Here's a lead pass for Coles. He'll put it up, no good. Young is going to draw the foul. Now we're going Coleman.
That'll be his second. Already in double bonus, so Tyler Young will get two.
Number five, Tyler Young.
Free throw up and in by Ronnell Blevins. Tyler Young hits one out of two. It's 39-26. At the other end, Lamb shot put up. That one no good. Rebound put back up and in by Coleman. It's 41-27. 14-point lead. Coles is going to drive and score and foul. Count to basket. Foul on Bluefield.
That'll go on Coleman. That's his third. So I got Edwards and Coleman for Bluefield, both with three. be Bailey Cole's second chance for a plus one.
And he hit it, 41-30. Cole's now with 7 points and a half. Down to 10 seconds left. Here's Cruz out top. Sends it right side, three ball put up, no good. Tipped up in the end by Bluefield's Russ Coleman. Half will come to an end with a score of Bluefield 43, East 30. You're listening to the Rudy's Halftime Show on 103.1 FM. 2 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned earlier tonight, we have a special presentation on behalf of the American Heart Association, whose mission it is to build healthier lives free of cardiovascular disease and stroke. Our guest here tonight to make that presentation is a West Virginia native from Charleston, West Virginia. He's lived in Greenbrier County over 20 years and is board certified in echocardiography and nuclear cardiology. All tests such as nuclear stress, echo, and carotid Doppler are done in the Heart Center facility.
Hey, some nice cash flying in over my head here. You sure you don't want any tickets for Monday?
Greenbrier,
all right. Got six.
Tom Von Dolan.
Hey, what's up?
How are you doing?
Good.
High cholesterol, diabetes, sedentary lifestyle, and in many cases, family history.
I appreciate it.
Could I have anybody in the audience who has a relative or has heart disease stand? I'd like to see what the impact is.
This radio spot, they haven't told me how many they want to do or when they want to run it yet.
After I said that, did you get a second email?
Yeah.
They want to do something completely different.
Even in some cases,
I'll let you know.
Okay.
Those of you in high school, they need to have your cholesterol check.
Halftime to Spartan Gym in Fairleigh with our score, Bluefield 43, East 30. As the Spartans jumped out early on Bluefield, they led it by as many as 8, 14-6. And then Bluefield went on an incredible run. At one point, Bluefield went on a 25-3 run. Or they went on a 20-0 run. Whichever way you want to look at it, neither of them are very good.
They're both impressive. I mean, let's be honest. And they, it all starts with turnovers, Jeff. It all started at Greenbrier East with 17 turnovers in the first half. When you turn the ball over, you know, the one thing Bluefield can do, no matter who's there, is they can run and get out and shoot layups. When you turn it over, you give them those opportunities.
We'll come back and we'll talk with Dr. Tom Von Dolan from the Heart Center in Lewisburg. When we return, you're listening to the Rudy's Halftime Show on 103.1 FM. All right, 2 minutes.
It's time to play basketball musical chairs. When the music starts, the contestants begin dribbling the ball around the circle of chairs. When the music stops, they dribble the ball into the basket of their choice and shoot until they make it, then dribble back and take a seat. We will remove a chair after each round until a champion is crowned. Here are our contestants tonight. Number one, Ethan Holliday. Number two, Elijah Brookman. Number three, Gage Blevins. Number four, Brody Hammer. Number five, Jacob Barker. Number six, Sam Rochelle. I hope I got that right. Probably not. Number seven, Noah Staten. And number eight, McKenna McClure. And number nine, Reed McGraw. All chairs are set up and ready to go. Let's see. Okay. I believe we're ready. On your mark. Get set. Start dribbling. Go. four seats are filled. Five seats, six seats. Coming down the line.
Yeah.
Please give a round of applause to our eliminated contestant, number two, Elijah Brookman. Thank you, Elijah. And we're removing the chair. I think we're ready. Begin the music there, Maestro.
Back inside the Spartan Gym in Fairley. We're at halftime. Bluefield leading Greenbrier East here by a score of 43-30. This is a rent-out game sponsored by the American Heart Association, and we're joined again this year as we always have been the last. How many years have we done this now, Doc?
This is going on 6 years.
6 years. So we're talking with Dr. Tom Von Dolan from the Heart Center here in Lewisburg. He's board certified in cardiology, graduate of the University of Georgia and West Virginia University Medical School, originally from Charleston. And before we start talking about this, I got to ask you, Georgia Bulldogs made an incredible run, and I know you're a graduate, a proud graduate. You're also a big Bulldog fan.
Yes, sir. I am. They had a great year.
They did have a great year, and I have to admit, I was pulling for them. Right at the very end, I kind of went with Saban, but I knew you were a Bulldog fan, so I was pulling for you to enjoy a national champion. I was really torn on that. I'm telling you, it was tough on me.
It was tough on me sitting in the end zone watching that last pass be caught.
Were you right in front of it?
Yes.
I knew you went. But, you know, that's incredible to get a chance to go like that. But Georgia will be back. Kirby Smart's got him in the right direction, and it didn't take him long, did it?
He sure does.
Doc, let's talk here for a minute. Heart disease is the number one killer in both men and women.
Yes. Actually, it outnumbers the other five leading causes of death in this country in total. Just for cardiac disease in men and women.
I know that, winter snow, there are precautions that people need to be aware of. We had a real heavy, wet snow on Sunday here in the Greenbrier Valley, and it was hard enough trying to walk through it, let alone trying to shovel it.
Yes, indeed. And especially folks who haven't been very active and decide to do the weekend warrior thing and go out and try to shovel like crazy. Sometimes it leads to problems, and you have to be aware of any new symptoms that might be occurring during those circumstances.
You know, snowblowers are a pretty good investment. They really are. Yes. Are they not?
Yeah, they are. Especially the self-propelled ones.
The self-propelled ones work. I don't have a self-propelled one. I've got one that takes a little bit of push to it, but it is motorized. And those things, again, something like that you really don't think as much about as you begin to get older is something that people really need to consider.
Yes, it is.
I know heart disease isn't just for the elderly. What are some of the warning signs and risk factors even in younger patients?
Most things that have to do with heart actually obey the laws of supply and demand. So anything that's new in terms of unusual shortness of breath or any symptoms that are brought on by exertion or emotion are important to pay attention to. And in the odd circumstance, anything that's a sudden onset of symptoms, and that could, the classic history is pressure in the chest or feeling heaviness. Most people don't call it pain, actually. It's something other than that. But it oftentimes is associated with breaking out in a sweat or being nauseated or other indications that really let you know something was going on and that you feel sick.
Your office complex, the Heart Center, is located just past Greenbrier East High School, just past Eastern Greenbrier Middle School, down at the turn here on Davis Stewart Road. Easy to find, right on the corner, big sign out front. Know it's your place, the Heart Center. What services do you offer to Heart Center?
We offer diagnostic services for cardiac disease. We do stress testing both with nuclear imaging and echocardiography. Regular echoes, carotid defect studies, rhythm monitoring with Holter monitoring, pacemaker and defibrillator follow-ups, and preventive services, including lab work.
They can give you a call at the office and set up an appointment?
Yes, sir.
So they don't need a referral from another doctor? They can just come to you directly?
No, and we participate with our insurances.
Very good. Doc, hey, thanks a lot. And you said this is, I knew it'd been a few years. I'm sorry, they're starting to run together a little bit for me. But this is the sixth year. And at least this year, we got beyond the first quarter, because if you remember last year's red out game against Princeton, that's the night the lights went out midway through the first quarter. We didn't get back on the entire game, so just had a quarter of the red out that night.
I guess I'm not a jinx after all.
Not at all. Not at all. Doc, thank you. I've told you in the past, you've been an incredible doctor and friend to my parents, and I really appreciate that. I'm telling you, you just went above and beyond, and I really am thankful for that. So you're a great, great man in my book.
Thank you, Jeff. Thanks for the opportunity to be with you.
You're always welcome, okay? Dr. Tom Von Dolan of the Heart Center, right here in Lewisburg, right down on Davis Stewart Road. It is the American Heart Association Redout here tonight from the Spartan Gym in Fairleigh. We're at halftime with our score, Bluefield 43, East 30. It's a 13-point lead for Beaver. We'll return. You're listening to the Rudy's Halftime Show on 103.1 FM. 2 minutes. Back in Fairleigh, Casey Crane's got a look at the first half stats here.
All right, scoring first for Bluefield: Cooper 2, Blevins 9, House 4, Edwards 5, Coleman 11, and Cruz 12 points. Shooting for Bluefield the first half, they were 17 of 31 overall from the field, 55%. 2 of 11 from 3, 18%. 7 of 9 from the foul line, 77%. Spartans, 9 of 31 from the field, 29%. 3 of 9 from 3, 33%. 9 of 11 from the foul line, 81%. Leading scorer for the Spartans right now, Corey Beswick with 9.
It'll be Bluefield basketball to begin this third quarter. All right, here's the inbound. Bluefield has it out front. Juice Edwards with it. Over to Cruz. They try a little alley-oop action and got a foul called down low on East. First singer.
That'll be his first, team number one. 9 seconds in, first foul.
He was falling out of bounds.
Calling that a two-shot situation. Referee says House was going up for the ball in a, you mentioned an alley-oop attempt, I guess. I didn't quite see it that way. I thought he was just throwing it up in the air for him.
I completely agree with you on that. The second one is good. So, House was 6, 45-30, 15-point Beaver lead. Back on the left side is Beswick into Jeter. He'll lay it up and score. Jeter now with six. 45-32.
One of the officials getting on assistant Jared Patton there and told him not to say anything else. So he's benched really chippy tonight.
Bluefield works a down ball, tipped out front. Cruz open three, shoots from there, no good. Rebound Persinger. Devin Persinger down the floor, gives it off to Lemons. 10-footer right side, good. Lemons makes it 45-34. Underneath, here's a drive by Juice Edwards. That one's no good. Rebound controlled here by Jeter. Lead pass down to Lemons. He'll drive and draw the foul. He'll shoot two.
That foul should go on Edwards, Jeff, and that is. That's his fourth. That will be Juice Edwards' fourth. Big blow there. Just under 7 minutes here in the third. And probably their best player tonight that we've seen historically. He's going to be sitting for a while with four fouls. That's team foul number one. Lemons will get two. You know what, Jeff, in all seriousness, that was just a dumb foul by Edwards.
Yeah.
Lemons beat him clearly.
Especially when you know you got three.
And, you know, the only thing he could do was foul. Lemons was already by him, and Edwards just came running in behind and grabbed his arms. There's no chance anything could come out of that besides a foul.
Lemons makes one out of two. Rebound to Beaver. 45-35, 10-point lead for Bluefield. Cruz, left wing. Back on the left side to the corner to Blevins. Back out top to Cruz. 6:40 to play, third quarter. They'll work it back to the right to Cooper. Bounce pass out front to Blevins. Into the elbow, over to House. They'll drive inside. That is going to be a Cooper layup shot and score. Chandler Cooper makes it a 12-point lead again, 47-35. And steal by Bluefield. Coleman, corner, Cruz, three, no. Rebound pulled in here by Beswick. Lead pass down to Persinger, driving layup, no good. Beswick cleans up the rebound. Gives it over to Lemons. Cross courts, left side, Coles, drives, dumps, Jeter, score. What a pass inside from Coles. Jeter cashes it in. 47-37 now. Here's Chandler Cooper, gives it up on the right side to Blevins. Over to Cruz, back over to Blevins on the left side.
He's playing 2-3 zone defensively, and Bluefield seems content to pass around the perimeter.
Down the baseline, here's the shot put up by House, is no good. Lemons rebounds and is fouled.
That will go on House, that's his third. So now you got House for Bluefield with three, Jeff, Coleman with three, and Edwards on the bench with four for a team that has very little depth coming in tonight between Collier being out and some sickness. I think they'll get tight here down the stretch for Bluefield.
Inbound comes in Priest.
If you're East, you got to take advantage of this.
Lemons, corner, Beswick, a three. Yes, it's down to seven. Beswick with 12. It is 47-40. Chipping away. We got a double foul down low. Jeter for East. Oh, they just called a single foul. Sorry.
Jeter's third, team second.
Tyler Young will check in for Jeter.
The thing that hurts about taking Jeter out, Jeff, I think he's your best athlete. He's the one guy down low that matches up athletically if these Bluefield kids have been able to get off the floor and play above the rim.
Under five to play in the third. Here's Cruz between the circles. Goes over on the right side, a corner three. Blevins up, yes, and a foul. A chance for a four-point play. Wow.
That'll go on Beswick. That's his third. Can't say I saw that one.
I didn't see it either, and I'm not saying it was a bad call. I'm just saying I didn't.
Yeah, you're like
didn't
me.
See what happened.
Once
I'm right
the shot
now,
goes off, you're following the ball.
Shot no good for Blevins. Rebound down to Bluefield. Tie up possession East. It's 50-40.
Now Logan Taylor will check in for Beswick.
Inbound for East. Here's Persinger. Gives it over now to Taylor into the front court. Lemons, baseline 10-footer. Good. Nathan Lemons now with 11. 50-42. Spartans down by 8. Cruz out front with it. And a steal. Here's Taylor. Leads it. Down to Lemons. Lemons drives, shoots, score, and a foul! 4:20 to go in the third. Lemons will have a chance for the three-point play.
That's on House. That's his fourth now. So now you've got two starters for Bluefield, Jeff, with four fouls before the four-minute mark of the third quarter.
Lemons puts it up. Yes. He's got 12. 50, 45, it's down to 5. Bluefield trapped. They'll send it out front now to Coleman. Up top to Cruz. He's going to kind of match up out of a 2-3 zone.
Really stretching it out, trying to cut down the perimeter shooting.
Here's House, 10-footer in the lane. No good. Rebound Taylor. Spartans could cut it even more. Gives it off now to Coles. Here comes Coles. Coles will drive. Feeds it over to Lemons. A three ball up in the air. Yes! Timeout, Buster Large! 50-48. The Spartans have clawed to within two. Spartans basketball's on 103.1 FM. Full timeout, 60-60.
Lemons with 11 this quarter. I got him for 9. I got him for 11 this quarter. How many do you have him for?
15 for the game.
I got him for 17.
You got 17.
Huh?
He's got him for 17.
Okay. Spartans down by 2 points, Casey, and it's been a third quarter that Nathan Lemons has really turned it up.
Yeah, he has scored 11 points for the Spartans in this quarter, 17 for the game, really. He's played well. He's had 2 and 1s this quarter for 6 points. He knocked down a three, and he hit a baseline jumper. So he's played, and that's the Nathan. Jeff, you and I said before the season started, for East to be successful, Lemons and Bestwick have got to carry the load offensively. We haven't seen it for a while. They're doing it tonight.
They've cut it down to 2. Bluefield, 3 ball, right side, shot no good. Rebound to Blevins, who tried the shot, and a travel called on Beaver. Lemons into the front court. Spartans can tie or take the lead on this possession. Persinger out top. Up top to Taylor. Back over to Tyler Young. Down low. Shot. Score! Tyler Young has tied the game. 50-50 with 3 minutes left in the third. Spartans had trailed by as many as 15 points.
Outscored Bluefield right now 20-7 this quarter.
Shot missed by Bluefield, and a foul on the floor on the rebound.
Was that 12 or 21? That was on Coles, 12. That's his third, team fourth.
Inbound for Bluefield, corner three by Cruz. No, rebound Tyler Young. Bimbo told him, he said, get some rebounds, and that's what he's just done. Drive in by Persinger's going to draw a foul. Floor foul on Beaver.
If that's on Coleman, who's in the spot, no, they'll call it on
Taxley.
That'll be his second. If it was Coleman, he'd be another player with 4. He's in there playing with 3, and he was right there in the mix on that foul. Team foul number 4.
Inbound for East. We're tied at 50. Coles drives and draws the foul.
That is on Coleman, Jeff. That'll be his fourth. Team fifth.
Bluefield in some foul trouble.
Yeah, you're talking House with four, Edwards four, and now Coleman four. That'll send Bailey Coles to the line. He's got 7 points. He's 3 of 4 at the foul line. He'll get a pair.
Shot is up. Good. Spartans lead.
Now you take out a player with four, Jeff. They bring House back in with four.
Second one, no good. Rebound, Bluefield. Foul on. Wait, whoa. What happened?
Bluefield stepped out
on the rebound.
Well, Bluefield was pushed out. That was a missed call that time. Tyler Young going for the ball basically pushed Taxley from Bluefield out. And they called him Taxley for stepping out of bounds. I think the official was blocked off in that angle. Just couldn't see Young pushing, going for the ball.
Lemons with it. Into Persinger. Brings it out on the elbow. Bounce passes. Lemons right side. Lemons works it around. Draws a double team. Lemons mug fires it up. Shot no good. Rebound Bluefield. All that, no foul. 2:15 left in the third. At the other end, blocking foul on Tyler Young.
That'll be his first, team fifth. Be two shots here for looks like Cruz.
It'll be Bluefield's Brandon Cruz. Foul shot, good. We're tied at 51. Second one, no good. Rebound to Bluefield. 2:12 left, third quarter. We're tied at 51. Beaver with it. Here's Cooper. Right side, kicks it over on the left wing. Three ball, Blevins, no. Rebound, Taxley, up, good. It's House, and a foul.
That foul will go on Penn. That'll be his first, team number six.
Shot up, no good, out of bounds. Tipped, it'll be Spartan ball. Bluefield leads at 53-51. Here's Persinger, over to Lemons. Down to Persinger, turnaround 12-footer, no good. Rebound, foul on Young.
That'll be Young's second, team seventh. So I've got that as a one-on-one situation for Bluefield. So they'll be shooting free throws the next minute 50 in the third and all the fourth. Spartans got to turn around tomorrow night, Jeff, and go to Cabell County for a late one tomorrow night. I'm hoping for weather. I'm really rooting for weather tomorrow.
You know, they are calling for a couple of inches of rain. Just saying.
Bus's hydroplane. Maybe we should think about canceling that one.
Cruz, free throw. No. Rebound, Bluefield. Another offensive rebound off a free throw. 53-51, Beaver. 1:40 left in the third. This game seems like it ought to be a minute and 30 to go in the fourth.
Well, it is after 9 already. We got a little bit of a late start. We've had a bunch of fouls, technicals.
Cruz, 3, yes. Brandon Cruz gives Bluefield 5-point lead, 56-51. Here's Coles, gives it over to Young. Now to Penn, right side, Taylor, corner, Beswick, 3, no. Rebound to Young. He'll turn, he'll go up with it and draw the foul.
That will go on Blevins. That'll be his second, team six. Young will go to the line and get a pair. He's got 4 points, Jeff. He's 2-2 at the foul line. And he's done just what you said Coach Coles told him to do. Get in there and rebound. Nice job. He was the only white jersey between four Bluefield defenders that time, Jeff, and he came up with the ball.
Here's a shot up. No good. That's missed by Blevins. Second one good. Tyler Young's got five, and it's 56-52. Minute to go, third quarter. Here's Cruz. Gives it over to Blevins. He'll drive. Give it off on the right elbow to House. Down to 45 seconds to go. Bluefield might be a little content here. Run some clock, but now here's a shot in the lane, missed by House. Rebound is controlled. And
that's on House.
Wow.
That's what they call it on. It will go on Taxley instead. It'll be Taxley's third. So every time there's a foul called, Bluefield guys around, you're expecting somebody to foul out in the third quarter. Tyler Young will go back to the other end. He'll shoot a 1-1 here. He's 3-4 at the line.
Young's foul shot, no good. Rebound Bluefield. It's a 4-point lead now with 30 seconds to go in the third. Cruz with it out front. Cruz drives, beautiful bounce pass underneath, and a foul called as Jaheim House goes up. Personal goes on Persinger.
That'll be Persinger's second, team eight. Should be two shots here for House.
Free throw's good. House with nine. Persinger, Penn, Young out. And the second one is good. House with 10, 58 to 52.
Jeff, the reason why he came back so far in this game, one turnover in the third quarter.
Coles drives, Lemons, corner, open, three, yes. Lemons with 20 points, 14 and a quarter. Down to 5 seconds. Bluefield travels with it. Spartan ball with 3 seconds left in the third. Down by three, 58-55. Inbound to Lemons. Lemons lets it go. A three at the buzzer. Oh, banked out. Bluefield 58, East 55. Fourth quarter coming up. Spartan basketball is on the Bear. Thank you. after three. 58-55, Bluefield leads by three, but the Spartans outscore Beaver 25-15 in that third quarter of play.
And really the biggest difference, Jeff, besides, I mean, Lemon's going Michael Jordan there that quarter and scoring 14 points, was the fact that East only committed one turnover. If you do that, if you could do that for most of the game, you can handle about anybody. When you start
do that in the fourth quarter, you're going to win the game.
Yeah, you're going to win the game. Because Bluefield only made four shots that whole quarter. East made nine. They shot the ball well, and it got a lot more shots. Bluefield only had 14. Greenbrier East, well, actually, Bluefield outshot East, but that's because Bluefield keeps getting all those second chances. They had four offensive rebounds on missed free throws that quarter. That's their game right now. Is they let Cruz shoot a three. Cruz and Cochran shoot the threes. Cruz and Blevins, excuse me. And House goes to the middle and just tries to get her offensive rebound.
Shot missed by Bluefield. Taylor rebounds over to Beswick. Now to Lemons. Down the floor. Jeter drives. Shoots. Scores. What ball movement. Four Spartans touched it on that.
Now Jeter, the third Spartan in double figures tonight to go with Beswick Lemons.
58-57. Jeter with 10, as you said. Bluefield now. Right side. Two-pointers up and good for Juice. 60-57.
Bluefield right now, Jeff, has three of their five players on the court, have four fouls to start the quarter.
Here's Beswick, works baseline, rejected by Cruz, carried out of bounds by Brandon Cruz. Inbound comes in to Beswick, over to Lemons. Spartans can tie on this possession. That's a three by Lemons. No good. Rebound to Bluefield. Up the floor with it comes House. Now to Cruz. Cruz drives, shoots. No rebound, Jeter. He'll give it off to Beswick. Fours. 62-57. 6.5 left in the game. Beaver by five. Lemons over to Taylor. He'll fire the three. Shot, no. Rebound, Bluefield. House with it. He'll work it over the right side. Ball knocked out of bounds. Spartan basketball. Into the front court. Comes East. 2 minutes gone by in the fourth. Lemons to Beswick. Beswick out to Jeter. He'll penetrate. Put it up. Shot no. Rebound to House. Gives it off to Cruz. Knocked away again. And Jeter with a steal. To Lemons. Front court. Beswick drives. Lean. Shoots. Scores. 14 for Corey Beswick.
And that was a good heads-up move by Beswick going right into Cochran. He's got four fouls, can't play. I mean, he just kind of got out of the way.
Bluefield by three. Here's a drive underneath. Layup shot good for Cooper. 64-59. Approaching 5 minute mark. Coles in the lane. Floater good. Bailey Coles landed a little bit weird on his ankle there. Looks like he kind of pulled up a little tender. 64-61. Here's Cooper underneath. Ball knocked away. Controlled by Cruz. Cross courts. Left side for Juice. Three. No. Jeter. Rebound. Gives it over to Taylor. East down by three with the ball. Here comes Coles. Over to Lemons for a three. We're tied. Lemons with 23. 64-64. Timeout Beaver. 4:25 to go. You're listening to Spartan Basketball on 103.1 FM. 60. Thank you.
No overtime. No overtime.
Cheryl comes over.
It's the 60. All is Nathan Lemons having an incredible night. 23 points, 17 in the second half.
He's playing outstanding basketball right now. And this is what we've been missing in some of these games. We've had these 30-point, 40-point games. Just Lemons not been able to find his shot tonight. He's feeling it.
Up front, Cruz for a three. Yes, gosh. He's got 19. He's had a really good game. 67-64, under 4:20 to go.
Right now, every time East feels like they're grabbing momentum, Bluefield gets it right back on the next possession.
Pulls out top, bounce passes, Beswick. Timeout. 30-second timeout. Bluefield leads it by three. Spartan basketball is on the bear. 30. To play, 67-64. Bluefield leads. Spartans have possession. Taylor to inbound, gets it into Jeter. Jeter will pull it out. And what do we got? Foul away from the ball. That one goes on Bluefield's Juice Edwards. And say goodnight to Juice with 7 points. He'll foul out with 3:51 to play. That's his fifth personal foul as Juice will foul out.
Now Blevins will check back in.
Coles at the line. First one, yes. Second one coming up. It's in the air, no good. Rebound Bluefield, 2-point lead, 67-65. 3:45 to play. Bluefield has it to the foul line for House. Working over to Cruz on the right side. He'll bring it between the circles. Sends it down inside. Driving shot is up and good for Bluefield's Russ Coleman. 69-65, a two-possession lead. 3.5 to play. Here's Beswick. Finds a seam, drives, off the glass. No, Jeter scores! 69-67. Down to 3:04 to go. Cruz over to Blevins. Now the elbow, 15-footer banked in for Bluefield's Jaheim House. 71-67. 2:50 to play. Coles gives it over to Jeter. Finds a seam, drives, can't finish. Rebound Bluefield. Beaver ball with a 4-point lead. Cruz is fouled by Lemons. They'll get him for a reach.
That'll be Lemons' second, team ninth. That'll send Cruz to the line for a 1-1.
And the foul shot's good for Brandon Cruz. He's got 20-point night now. 5-point lead, 72-67. Hit them both. 6-point lead. Cole's out front. Works it down the left side. Coles will drive, put it up. Shot short, rebound. Comes down to East. Here's Coles with it again. Shot rejected. Bluefield rebounds. 2:10 to play. Beaver ball with a 6-point lead. They'll give it over to Cooper.
Looks like Bluefield trying to spread things out a little bit, being in such bad foul trouble, so they can just run some clock. East will probably have to come out and man this up.
Here's Cruz. Coles comes down on him with 1:45 to go. Down to 1:40 to go. Coles has to come out. Defensively, they're on Cruz. 90 seconds to go. Bluefield works it around to Cruz. Down in the right corner.
A foul on Blevins.
With 1:15
to play. Lemons. That'll be his third. Team 10th. A double bonus now. That'll send Cooper to the line. He's got 6 points on the evening.
And the shot is good.
That makes it three possessions also.
Yep. Second one, good. Cooper makes it 75-67. Here's Coles, feeds it over now to Taylor. Logan drives, floater in the lane, no good. Rebound, Jeter puts it up, can't fall. Bluefield rebounds. Under a minute to go, Bluefield by 8. Foul called on East.
I think that's on Lemons.
Taylor
instead. It could have called on either one. That'll be Taylor's third. So to send Cruz back to the line.
Foul shot good for Cruz. And it's a 10.4 possession lead. 55 seconds to go. Here's Coles. We got an offensive foul.
That's on Lemons.
Yep. Legal screen.
That'll be his fourth. That's a turnover also. Only the second turnover this quarter. You said if they only got one, Jeff, they'd win. That way, too. That's going to probably end up costing us.
Yeah.
That's a foul on Lemons. That's his fifth. He fouled grabbing, so that's five on Nathan Lemons. He'll foul out after an outstanding night tonight with 23 points. Now Clay Jackson will check in. Tough spot for Clay coming in. 45 seconds ago, hadn't been in all evening. Really, you know, played some JVs, cooled down. You know, played JV game 2 hours ago, 2.5 hours ago, in setting. So he's got a bright future. It's just tough coming in this situation. Cruz makes the first.
78-67 now.
Cruz has now made 11 free throws tonight.
78-67, second one no good, rebound. Bluefield, Cooper misses, foul on the rebound. They're going to get Taylor on that one. with 42.6 to go.
That'll be Taylor's fourth. That'll send House to the line. House has got 12 points. He's 4 or 5 from the foul line.
House now with 13, 79, 67. Still the same. Missed the second one. Down to 40 seconds to go. Here's Taylor, long three out front, no good. Rebound knocked around. It's going to be controlled here by Bluefield. Cruz now with 30 seconds to go, 12-point lead. Gives it out top to Cooper. 20 seconds. Bluefield going to try to run the clock out. Let's not foul.
I heard Coach Cole yell, don't foul.
Well, they let him, okay. House scored. 81-67, and that will do it. Final score, Bluefield 81, Greenbrier East 67.
Well, thank you for attending tonight's game. And remind you that on Monday evening we'll have the Lady Spartans and James Monroe.
We'll return to Spartan basketball on 103.1 FM. We call it the Cornerstone IGA postgame. See ya.
What's up? How you doing?
You want stats this break? I'm ready. You want to do one? This break, you want to do this segment, break, and come back to tomorrow night's game and be done. I mean, hell, we're already 9:30.
Back in Fairley, we are in the Cornerstone IGA postgame right here on 103.1 FM. KC Spartans, man, they're close. They're so close, and they played Bluefield tight tonight. Just kind of got a final score here. As, you know, it was a four-point game with just under 3 minutes to go, 71-67. Actually, two-point game with 3 minutes, 69-67.
And it wasn't turnovers. It's just a matter of Bluefield executed better. We had some good shots. Jeter got a couple good looks down at the post, just not able to convert. We just missed a couple shots, and Bluefield was able to convert. And they had when he started fouling, they had to – Bluefield able to make the free throws, and what was basically a four-point game becomes a 14-point game because of at the foul line. But it really was. The game was much closer than the score indicates.
Time now for our Greenbrier Valley Physical Therapy Player of the Game. And tonight, boy, he fouled out but played his tail off, especially in that third quarter that pulled the Spartans back into this game as East outscored Bluefield 25-15 in the third. Nathan Lemons finishes up with 23 points. Great second half.
Really did. When he hit the three in the fourth quarter, I think it tied us. I thought at that point, East was going to find a way to win this game. But Bluefield, give those guys credit. They know how to play tough games. They were able to just make things happen down the stretch.
Go ahead in the final
stats. All right, scoring first for Bluefield. Cooper with 8. Blevins, 14. House, 15. Edwards, before he fouled out, had 7. Coleman, 13. And Brandon Cruz, 24. Shooting for Bluefield tonight, they were 28 of 56 overall from the field, 50%. 5 of 22 from 3, 22%. And 20 of 26 from the foul line, 77%. Scoring for the Spartans, Jeter had 12. Lemons, you mentioned, 23. Beswick, 14. Young, 5. Coles, 11. And Persinger, 2 points. Shooting for the Spartans tonight, they were 23 of 58 overall from the field, 40%. 7 of 17 from 3, 41%. And 14 of 21 from the foul line, 67%. Add all up. Bluefield 81, Greenbrier 67.
We'll come back, tell you about our next broadcast. This is the Cornerstone IGA postgame on 103.1 FM. 2 minutes.
How are you all?
Back at the Spartan Gym for our final go-around as Bluefield defeats East tonight, 81-67. And Spartans played hard. They really did. Just Bluefield made too many plays down the stretch, but this team, as we said, getting better most nights anyway, and this was one of the nights that they did get better.
I would feel safe to say this is probably our most complete game of the season.
Probably.
I mean, I don't know why. We match it, with the exception of the first quarter, Bluefield, we match up well with these guys.
But the Spartans do fall tonight, and it's on to the next game, and that game is coming up tomorrow night here from the Let me rephrase that. It's not a home game. It would have been on your schedule. So if you've got a schedule early in the year, it said Cabell Midland at home on February the 10th. That is now a road game. So if you show up here tomorrow night, there's not going to be anybody here in Fairley for the basketball game because it is at Cabell Midland now.
Let's because root for the weather tomorrow. Let's root for bad weather.
The original schedule, if you still got one of those pocket schedules, it's got an H beside Cabell Midland on February the 10th. That game is now on the road at Cabell Midland tomorrow night. So don't come here. Go to Cabell Midland. Exit 17, right? Exit 17, Barbersville. Get off the exit, hang a left, go the T in the road, take a left, go up a road, you'll see Cabell Midland.
I always go the Milton way.
I don't like that one. I like to go down to Barbersville. I like to see some action.
What are you going to see at
Chiefs in
Barbersville?
There's all kinds of you got the Huntington Mall there.
You don't even go to the mall. You take a left before you get to the mall.
But you can see the mall. But the game, the point of the matter is this. The game is at Cabell Midland tomorrow night. It's not in Fairley, according to what you still may have on an original pocket schedule.
The original schedule had us away to begin with, and we had switched it.
Not one that was printed.
Yes, one that was
Now, I've got one that was printed that says otherwise. Yes.
All right, let's wrap
I'll
up.
I'll bring it to you, okay? Our next Greenbrier East Spartan basketball broadcast coming up tomorrow night at Cabell Midland on the road in Ona between Barbersville and Milton. Airtime 7:15. Fritz's Pharmacy Spartan countdown. Tip 7:30 tomorrow night. East at Cabell Midland. East at Cabell Midland Saturday night right here on 103.1 FM. That'll do it from here. Final score, Bluefield 81. East 67 for Ralph Church over at Fairlea Studio. Casey Crane, Jeff Campbell, good night from Fairlea.